you know, this keema unde or this mutton mince ball is soft to the touch. It's crumbly. A piece of the dosa that has soaked up all that gravy and some meat.
So good. It's so good.
So we are in North Bangalore and we are here to taste a very different style of meal. And this one, I'm told, is Naati Karnataka food or local Karnataka fare. So we are here at a restaurant called Naati Sogadu, a restaurant that doesn't have too much of a history, but I'm told they serve up some great food. So let's go in and check out local Naati Uta. So I'm here with Mr. Naveen, who's the owner of Naati Sogadu. So Naati Sogadu andre Naati Sogadu meaning enna?
Sir, Naati means the village.
Village.
Village style.
Okay.
The Sogadu means the strong essence, the aroma of the village.
The aroma.
Aroma, yeah.
So Naati Sogadu means the aroma of the village.
Village, yeah.
The scent of the land.
The scent of the land.
All right.
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ರೆಸ್ಟೋರೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ,
ಓಕೆ,
ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲ ಡಿಶಸ್ ಕೂಡ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ತಾಯಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಿಸ್ಸಸ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸೇಮ್ ಅದೇ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಅವ್ರದ್ದು ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಬಂದು ನಮ್ದು ಹಳ್ಳಿ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕುಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ನಮ್ಮ ತಾಯಿಯವರು.
ಓಕೆ.
ದಟ್ಸ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕಲ್ಸ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದು ಅವ್ರ ತಾಯಿ.
ಓಕೆ.
ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಸೊ ಜನರೇಷನ್ ಫುಡ್ನ ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತಂದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಒಂದು ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಅದು ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಉದ್ದೇಶದಿಂದ ನಾವು ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ಹೋಟೆಲ್.
This is the food that comes from their family, that comes from recipes that have been handed down through generations. They want to share this wonderful food, these recipes, with Bengaluru. And that's what led to Naati Sogadu. So, who's involved in the cooking of the various dishes?
My mother,
okay.
My wife, and my younger brother is a passionate chef.
Okay.
So, even he gets too much involved in cooking also.
All right. So, they're also, it's a family-run
enterprise. Enterprise, correct.
So, can we take a look at the kitchen
and
see some dishes being cooked?
Sure, not.
All right. So, let's go in the kitchen here at Naati Sogadu and watch some of those dishes being cooked before we sit down for a meal here. A Naati style, a local style meal. Let's go. Your family?
Yes, sir. This is my family.
All right.
This is my mother.
Okay.
This is my
Namaskara.
Wife.
Namaskara.
My brother.
Hi.
So you are actually lala cook modadella ivrane.
They are responsible for all the
all the dishes which comes out from the kitchen. They are all responsible for it.
Recipes ala nimdu recipes.
Namdella recipes.
Okay. So every day new masale ko prepare martira.
Prepare marti. So say nanu maga bandu mooru ippu kelsur kartagondu mele maadittu ella hogtivi.
I'm told that the dishes here are made to recipes that have been in the family. And every day, they make the masalas, they make it fresh, and then they give it to the cooks here at the restaurant, who cook it under the supervision of Naveen's brother, Nagendra. Why are you special here? The dishes are
powder. Powder.
All
natural.
I'm told what makes the dishes special here is the fact that everything is pure, natural, and freshly prepared. The masalas are ground fresh on a day-to-day basis. There is no use of tasting powders or any additives. So all that you taste really is the essence of the traditional recipes that are employed by the family. So cooking nodboda eno?
Sure.
En cook martta idira iga?
Iga keema ball pepper dry anta
maadta. Keema ball pepper dry. So we will watch one of the dishes, the keema ball pepper dry being cooked, and hopefully also taste that. So idenu keema
ball?
Keema ball curry.
Curry.
Enen hogide idralli?
ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮಸಾಲೆ ಕೊತ್ತಂಬರಿ ಸೊಪ್ಪು ಪುದೀನ ಸೊಪ್ಪು
ಓಕೆ
ಮತ್ತೆ ಕೊಬ್ಬರಿ ಶುಂಠಿ ಬೆಳ್ಳುಳ್ಳಿ
ಓಕೆ
ಚಕ್ಕೆ ಲವಂಗ
ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಹೋಲ್ ಬಂಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪೈಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಕೀಮಾ ಬಾಲ್ ಕರಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ನೌ ಬಿ ಮೇಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ಕೀಮಾ ಬಾಲ್ ಫ್ರೈ ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಡಿಶ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ ರೈಟ್ This will dry up and this will become the mutton keema ball fry. I can already smell these beautiful aromas that are wafting from that kadai of mutton keema ball fry as it's being prepared. The reason why it's so aromatic is that everything is prepared fresh. They prepare it like they prepare in their own home, and that's the only way they know to prepare these dishes. You can see all the gravy of that mutton curry getting concentrated. It's all coming together, which means also that the flavors in the curry are intensifying. So the mutton keema ball pepper fry is ready. I can't wait to taste this on the table.
This is mutton biryani.
Mutton biryani.
Mutton biryani. It's actually pulao, mutton pulao. But people these days call it as mutton biryani as well.
Mandre, actually it is a pulao.
Yes, it's a pulao.
Right, so there's the mint and the coriander that goes into it, and also along with some green chilies. Spicy rate,
medium.
Medium spicy. Andre, idu rice matte meat ottige cook martira
nee.
That pulao certainly looks delicious, and I'm going to be tasting that soon. So we've just emerged from the kitchen into the restaurant. All around me, the restaurant is packed. Every single table taken, every single chair taken. You can hear the clatter of utensils, you can hear the clatter of plates. You know, it's always such a reassuring sign when you walk into a restaurant, there's nobody there. But in a few minutes, the restaurant fills up. My expectation from this meal has already shot up. I can never say this enough. Always a happy feeling eating off a banana leaf. So I have the menu here. It's a compact menu, but there's a smattering of other dishes too. So there's a smattering of Chinese, there's some Punjabi, but we are here for the Naati style uta. We are here for the Naati dishes, the local dishes. So in special is the Naati only.
Normally, banda highlight banda Naati.
Naati.
ಅದರೊಳಗೆ pepper chicken, chili chicken, mutton body ಗೆ Naati chicken liver fry.
Naati chicken liver fry. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ನಾಟಿ ಚಿಕನ್ ಲಿವರ್ ಫ್ರೈ ಕೊಡಿ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ಕೀಮಾ ಬಾಲ್ ಪೆಪ್ಪರ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಕೊಡಿ, ಬೋಟಿ ಗೊಜ್ಜು ಕೊಡಿ, ಒಂದು ನಾಟಿ ಚಿಕನ್ ಬಸಾರು, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ರಾಗಿ ಮುದ್ದೆ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ವೈಟ್ ರೈಸ್, ಮಟನ್ ಕರಿ ಕೊಡಿ, ಮಟನ್ ಕರಿ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಮದು ದೋಸೆ ಕೊಡಿ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಲಾಸ್ಟಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅ ಆರ್ಡರ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ಡರ್ಡ್ ಅ ಸ್ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಶಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡಿಶಸ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್. I can smell all this good food in the air, and I'm just waiting for the dishes to arrive, and I think my dishes have arrived. So we have all the dishes that we've ordered and some more. Let's run through all the dishes that we've ordered. So of course we have here the chili chicken. I don't see too many chilies here, but probably the chili is kind of ground into the paste. You have the green chilies, you have the onions, you have the chicken of course. So this is the Naati chicken liver fry, and you can see this is the egg that comes from the chicken that is still attached on the inside. This is the Naati chicken bassaru. So basically this is a gravy that's first cooked with the chicken and coriander and some other herbs and masala. And then this chicken is taken out and then tossed again with some coconuts, with some rice flour, and I can also see some chana here. I'm sure there's some spices that have gone into it. You eat this with the ragi mudde, and of course you also have the dosa here, which is more like a khali dosa style, and the dosa you will typically eat with the curry here. Now this is a boti here, and this is a boti gojju. Typically when you look at the boti preparations that you get elsewhere, it's usually a dry preparation, but this is a wet preparation, almost like a semi gravy. And then of course a couple of other specialities here. So you have the mutton keema ball fry, the pepper fry actually, we saw this being cooked. You have the mutton biryani, which is actually more of a pulao, and a dish that I hadn't ordered, but they said a lot of people order for this is the chicken lollipop. I think I should begin with the chili chicken. I can see all these onions that are coating each piece of the chicken. So get that chicken with some of that masala. You know that masala, that onion masala has a deep flavor. The slight sweetness of the onion. You've got that spike of the curry leaf. And the chili makes its presence felt in that gentle heat that remains on your palate even after you've tasted the dish. It's not a dish that's going to leave you crying in chili pain, but it just has that lingering sort of chili heat that you taste on your palate, on your tongue. Time to move on to the mutton, cheema, ball, pepper, fry. You know, this cheema unde or this mutton mince ball is soft to the touch, it's crumbly. And you know what that tells me? It tells me that I can taste the flavor of the meat. So sometimes what happens is when you have this cheema unde, to make the cheema hold together and to make those dumplings, there are other things that go into it as well. There are binders that go into it. But what happens is that it takes away from the flavor and also makes it a little tougher. But this is soft and you can taste the flavor of the meat and all that masala in this. You can certainly feel the heat of the pepper on your palate. Oh, this is good. So you have the deep roasted flavors of the masala that goes with the meat. I can feel the heat from the dishes slowly creep up. And the back of my head is moist. Always an indicator of that heat. I'm going to taste some of this chicken lollipop now. We didn't order for it, but they said we must try it because it's a popular dish that's ordered. I don't remember the last time I had a chicken lollipop. It's crunchy outside, soft inside. The masala has coated the chicken well. This is sort of tasty chicken lollipop, but I find it a wee bit out of place when I look at the other dishes on my table, and that's what we're going to go to next. Next, we're going to taste the Naati chicken liver fry. So this is the liver from the Naati chicken, the country chicken, the desi chicken. So this preparation also has the eggs from inside the chicken which are still attached to the egg sac. You know, I'm always a fan of the chicken liver over the mutton liver because I like its creaminess. I like the deep flavors that you get in the chicken liver. But what's interesting is that because this is a Naati chicken liver, it's not as powdery as the chicken liver that you would probably get in a broiler chicken or something like that. So the chicken liver too has bite along with those deep flavors. I'm going to taste the egg now along with the egg sac. It's been years since I've tasted this and I think this will bring back a memory. So you've got the creamy flavor of the egg yolk and then you've got that stretchy bite of the egg sac that the egg yolk is attached to. That bite takes me back, takes me way, way back. Time now to taste the boti goju. So you've got the intestine, you've got the liver, and then you also have these avare kalu or the hyacinth beans which are in season. So this is a very unusual preparation of the boti. I've never tasted this preparation before. It's got that gamey texture and flavor. You can literally taste the flavor of the animal.
You know, the avrekalu has this pasty texture, but what's interesting is that it has absorbed, soaked up all the flavors of the boti. If you don't like the intense, gamey, meaty flavor, then probably this is not a dish that you should order here. Next, we're going to taste this mutton curry. And this mutton curry, we're going to taste with this hot dosa. It's a dry, spongy sort of a dosa. It's got this slightly tart edge, but I think its texture makes it perfect to mop up some gravy, which is what I'm going to do. In fact, this dosa is the perfect medium to soak up any curry, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take all this curry and soak my dosa with it. And while I'm at it, also probably a piece of the meat. You know, that dosa soaks up all the flavors of the curry so beautifully well. So this dosa and curry combination is just so good. And the meat with a bit of the fat and with all its bite intact. Take some of the Bassaru. So this is where all the goodness of the meat, all the goodness of the chicken finds itself into this saru, into this thin gravy. And then the chicken, this I'm told is a speciality here. I want to just taste the gravy. Take a bit of the ragi mudde. The ragi mudde serves as the perfect medium to carry all those flavors of the basaru. You can definitely taste the tempering, the mustard seeds, the rawness of the spices actually. I'm going to taste this now with the chicken. That chicken is so soft. It almost disappears on the palate. You know, the chicken fat, the skin, the gelatin, all of that has rendered into that preparation. So I'm going to just taste a bit of the rice with the saru in this. If you love your ragi mudde, I guess there is no competition to the saru and the ragi mudde. But if you like your rice, I think the rice also goes very well with this thin yet flavorful gravy. Last but not the least, we have to taste the biryani here. And although they call it a biryani, it's actually a pulao. I'm quite stuffed at this stage, but this biryani certainly looks and smells very inviting. You also have the egg, the customary egg that makes that pulao go that much longer. The pulao is nice and warm to the touch. It's made with the small grain rice. I think this is the jeera sambar rice that's used in this. And it's got that gentle aroma. You know, I can also taste the mellow sweetness of fennel seeds, and I think that's also a flavor that I get in this pulao. Well, that's a very different flavor. So this is a piece of meat that was probably holding on to the vessel, so you can see it's almost caramelized with the heat of the vessel. Also making it a little too tough on the bite. You know, the meat feels a little dry to the touch, but I think that's a typical character of a pulao. when you're tasting a pulao, I think most of the flavor is in the rice. The meat, by virtue of having been cooked with the rice, imparts or gives up all its flavor to the rice, and that's why you find the flavor of the meat in the rice. And this pulao at Naati Sogadu certainly has all that flavor. You know, this establishment, Naati Sogadu, hasn't been around for too long. I think barely 8 or 9 months as we filmed this episode. But I'd heard a few things about this restaurant, which compelled us to make the drive from South Bangalore to North Bangalore, where this restaurant is located. And to be honest, I wasn't sure of what we would expect to find at the end of this drive. But after having tasted about 8, 9 or 10 dishes, including those delicious naati chicken or desi chicken, country chicken preparations, to the mutton curry, the mutton pulao, I would definitely say that a visit to Naati Sogadu is a must if you're looking to taste some delicious flavors of the land. I think the fact that there's a family that's standing behind this establishment, preparing the masalas, dishing out the food in the kitchen with their cooks, I think makes it all the more special. So for a taste of the local flavors of the land, do visit Naati Sogadu here in Namma, Bengaluru. Until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating. I'm going to go back to my Bassaru, and I'm told you can also drink it up as a soup.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!